first verse we are going to look at is 2 Peter 1, verse 4. You have to keep this in mind, because I keep on telling you that many Christians, they build their Christianity on minor things, leaving the major things. Instead of building their Christianity, their Christian life, on the major things, you understand? They build their Christianity on the minor things. Don't minor in the major. You understand? Tell somebody, I'm not going to minor on the major. I'm not going to
major in the
minor. I'm not going to major in the minor. I wanted to test you. To see if you got the spirit. Now I'm satisfied. Don't major in the minor. Okay. So everybody read this. Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises. What kind of promises?
Exceeding great and precious.
Are given unto us. Exceeding. Oh man, to all of us. Not just promises. Exceeding great promises. That by these promises, we might be what?
Partakers.
Of what?
The divine nature.
Okay. Tell me. If there is anyone close to you who answers bad, bring him in the front. We are going to deal direct deliverance. Only the devil can answer bad in this. Tell me. What exactly, what kind of nature God wants us to be and to operate in?
Divine nature.
Who said human? God wants his people to be and operate in divine nature.
Yes.
So you should not accept to operate just in human nature.
Amen.
That's not the will of God for you. Are you getting the point?
Yes.
Say,
I determine today.
From this day. I'm going to operate. In divine nature. I refuse to operate in human nature. You want to operate in which nature?
Huh?
Which nature you want to operate in?
Ah,
okay. Yeah. Okay. You escape. Because I was ready to for deliverance right now. Hey, glory. So, this is the will of God. God does nothing but according to the counsel of his will.
Yeah.
So if you don't desire to operate in the divine nature, you can be operating in anything, but know that it's not God.
Yeah.
Even if he does, it's not God. But he only does that which is according to the counsel of his will. So some of us, I should say, almost all of us, we have to make a change. We have to take a resolution. We have to be determined from this day. Because many of the church, they just operate in human nature. Sometimes even you hear, oh, I'm just a human. So you are not in agreement with God. But the Bible said that because God wants this so bad in his heart, God's heart is so yearning after this, that he has to make promises.
Yeah.
Not just promises. Exceeding. Which kind of promises?
Exceeding.
Look at that.
And precious promises.
So are you going to agree with God from this day or not?
Yes.
Or are you going to continue in iniquity?
Mm-hmm.
iniquity is continuing in my own ways. I don't want to agree with God. Do you understand? So, operating in divine nature, you need, what do you need to operate in divine nature? No, he gave promises so that we may reach that dimension. We may operate in divine nature. But what do you need? So, we all know, we had a retreat on it, that we need the Holy Ghost to fully operate. That's the way Jesus operates. You understand? It's the Holy Ghost who caused Jesus to operate in that nature. But he came as a human being. But he was not operating as a human being. Okay. We know that. But the fact that we know it, let me explain something to you. Give me Ephesians before we continue. Give me Ephesians chapter 4 from verse 13. So in Ephesians, Jesus gave, when he ascended, he gave gift to humankind. And the gift, the fivefold ministry to give from verse 11, the fivefold ministry, you see that, to, for the unity of the body of Christ, and gave some apostles and prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all, not some of us, we all,
yes,
tell somebody, including you and I,
we
all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. So the fivefold ministry are given so that we will come to this end result till the objective, the final goal. We all come to the unity of the faith, but which kind of faith? The faith that will allow us to know the Son of God. But which kind of knowledge? You have three kinds of knowledge. The first kind is intellect, the intelligence, the human knowledge, mind knowledge. You understand? But I tell you, no matter how much you know this chair, that will never make you to become a chair. Gnosis in Greek, mind knowledge, cannot transform you. It gives you information concerning the chair. Are you?
Yes,
you got that?
Good.
That's gnosis in Greek. Then the second dimension of knowledge is experiential knowledge. The Bible said that Joseph didn't know Mary. Joseph didn't know Mary until the first child was born. He didn't know Mary. But does that mean that he didn't know her mentally speaking? They are always together. He didn't experience her as
his wife.
Yeah. Experiential knowledge. And Mary also didn't experience Joseph as her husband. So you have experiential knowledge that is different from the mental knowledge. But no matter how much Mary knew Joseph and Joseph knew Mary, Joseph will never become Mary. He cannot transform Joseph to become Mary. Likewise, It doesn't depend on how much the king will know the queen. That will not make the king become the queen. King Joseph. He still remained the king. Right? So experiential knowledge can never transform him to become the queen. So experiential knowledge is different from mental knowledge. But one thing is sure, experience knowledge cannot transform you to become conformed to the object of your knowledge.
Yes.
Now you have this knowledge. This knowledge, until we all reach the knowledge of the Son of God. This knowledge, right, is not mental. It's not experiential.
Yeah.
This is the knowledge that is called epiosi, transformational knowledge. You are changed to become conform to the Son of God as a perfect man. And you are growing to become like him unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ.
Yes.
That's epiosis.
Yes.
Epiosis cause you the subject who knows, to be transformed until you become conformed to the object of your knowledge. That's what God wanted. And he established the fivefold ministry for that. Are you seeing the point?
Yes.
So now the fivefold ministry, you know the responsibility, but you have to be careful that because the gospel or the what is given to you, is it taking you in this process?
Yeah.
Or is it just exciting you? Mm-hmm. And even more than excitement and spectacular things, that which you don't realize with all the business that is going under the thing, what you don't realize is that you are victimized. Let me show you that. Go back to 2 Peter 1 verse 4. It's very dangerous. You are victimized because instead of growing in the stature of Christ, in the fullness of the stature of Christ, you are growing in corruption.
Whoa.
And covetousness.
Wow.
And you are excited with that growth. It's only when you are operating according to the divine nature that you can escape the corruption that is in the world through lust. I can preach to you right now that God is increasing your finances. God is breaking forth. You see, the church is changing. And I can sense that somebody is receiving his miracle. Oh, ra-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. You see, we become so sensitive to what we can get than how we can be, should be transformed. What we can get is more important to us and cause us to react than the transformation we should get. In God's mind, miracles should look for you. In God's mind. And when you are pressing after this to operate according to the divine nature, miracles should follow you, and God will see that miracle follow you. May God see that miracle are following you.
Amen.
in the name of Jesus. But when you reverse it, you are the one trying to find miracle. You hear that there is this, that over there. You run there for a miracle. You run for a prophecy. You run for a blessing. You have reversed the thing. Now it's not God who is bringing the miracle, because God will not work contrary to his word. It's somebody else who took the opportunity, because you are now covered in the lust and corruption. You are after what God said should be after you. Now somebody will find it, the opportunity to give you a miracle. And you receive a miracle. No! You receive something from the other one.
Mercy.
We have no choice. We must agree with God. We must agree with his word. Then we'll see God moving. We want that which is only from God. Not from another source. But if we reverse it, we are in our human nature, and the human nature has lost. Like to have things. Jesus said, these things should come after you. And now you are after the things. That means that's the human nature. And as the human nature are after the things, you are inviting the other one to operate for you. Then you put that in the account of God.
Mercy.
You better change before you find yourself somewhere else. That's why the Bible said the way of a man can appear to him as the right way, but the end of it is death. Are you getting the thing? Let me tackle you a little bit. Tease you a little bit. Okay. Can I tease you? It's between us. It's not out of bad. Two Christians. Right? Oh, look at this awesome man of God. I like the way he's dressed. He looks like a bishop. This one looks like a struggling pastor. One is after the kingdom of God. And the other one, so he's ministering the kingdom of God. And he's ministering the blessings of God. And people are running for the blessing. You understand? All his messages, bless you, bless her. You come, you will bless you. You have your breakthrough. You have your miracle. You have the. That's his message. That's his gospel. The other one is more after the kingdom. This will attract less people than this one. Right? This one will attract less. No? Okay. The way you're right. Yeah. You're right. The way he's dressed, this is the way the other people. He even have airplanes, 10 airplanes. You understand? It looks like the other one. So this is the one. You're right. She's in the spirit. You are the one preaching blessing, and his church is packed. Every week, every Sunday, he has to increase. This one is preaching the kingdom. Let me tell you, if your gospel is getting the people to get down here, the blessings, down here, on the earth, they can consume under. You understand? That gospel is not of God. Do all the miracle you want for them. Do all the blessings you want for them. That's not the gospel. The Bible said, the first thing first, you have to get the people to be looking the kingdom of God to come here.
Hallelujah.
Not the blessing to come in their lives.
Yeah.
The kingdom of God.
Yes.
Because God said, then I will pour my blessing into
yes.
them. Because they are looking for my kingdom.
Yes. Hallelujah.
But the corruption is so strong, rampant, that the people are running here instead of the kingdom. They are running to the miracles, while the miracles should be running after them. And because of this shifting that is not of the word of God, let me tell you, unless it's the mercy of God, that has nothing to do with God. What the blessings and the miracles are operating is operating from another source. So people are receiving things, but it's not of God. Some receive their husband, their wife. Before you know, divorce. The guy was not of God. Because you receive a wrong gospel. You receive an earthen blessing gospel would tie you to the earth. While Christianity is for you to be seeking the heaven, the kingdom of heaven. That's you, your heart must be after your redemption in Christ and you're going home one day and you are preparing for that to be pleased so that God will be pleased with you. You're after that. If a Christian is not growing to be more sensitive to heaven and be less sensitive to the things that you can get down here, all the blessings, the cars, the clothes. If you see somebody with, you can see those who like it. When they put the things and they are in their cars, the way they walk, they think they are, you understand? They have this, they have that. They have riches. They have this. You can see that they like it. That's the lust.
Yeah.
That is producing.
Yes.
That's the corruption.
Yes.
That is in the world.
Mm.
You understand? Unless that which you are hearing is causing you to think about eternity, heaven, your destination. The things of above. If the gospel you are hearing is not turning you toward this, that which you are hearing is not of God. You can see power, you can see miracles, you can see all kind of prophecy demonstration, and you can manufacture it as God. This is God. Oh, look at which precision is telling the name of the person. You didn't know your name. Nonsense. You cause people to be attached to the earth.
Yeah.
You better repent before you stand before Jesus.
Yeah.
You think Jesus came to attach you to the earth? He came for that? That's the reason why he died?
No.
For you to get all. Somebody will say, what will profit you to get the whole world? What will profit you? What can you give in exchange to your soul? He came so that your soul will escape death, be redeemed, and go to heaven one day. Not fall under the condemnation of sin.
Mm.
Now, after you accept Jesus, you are born again. Instead of operating, growing, and operating in the divine nature, you go back to the things that were supposed to seek for you.
Mm.
You don't know that the provision, the riches, the things down here, they feel blessed when they can come to you. Yeah, because the Bible said the whole earth is groaning, expecting the manifestation.
Yes.
So they sense that they will receive something, they will be promoted when they are serving me. Angels are fighting to come to serve you. Somebody who looks like God, Son of God. You think that's a small thing down here? That you should take it and give it. And you are the one seeking now for things. You're miserable. Things must be looking for you. Miracles should follow you. They should go to the post everywhere trying to find your address while you are resting in Christ.
Yes.
You are just celebrating.
Yes.
Take over.
Yes.
Take over.
Yes.
Jesus, take over.
Yes.
I cannot make it by myself.
Yes.
Holy Ghost, unless you take over.
Yes.
I cannot know you as you are.
Yes.
Unless you take over.
Yes.
So you are fellowshipping with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And they are fighting to find where you are.
Whoa.
That's how it is.
Yeah.
And if the gospel is not taking over there, it's taking you to corruption and lust. You understand?
Yes.
And now you get one thing, you want the second. You got the second, you want the third one. You will never be satisfied.
Yeah.
You have a yearning inside to always get more. You get the house, you want this. You get this car, you want the other. You get the plane, you want this. You get that. That's the kind of gospel that is developing inside of you. And greed.
Yeah.
Lust.
Yeah.
Convoitise.
Yes.
Corruption.
Yep.
Garbage. Huh? Covetousness.
Yeah.
That's the thing that it will be developing you. Never satisfy.
Yeah. Have mercy.
Thirsting for okay. Now, how you are going to operate in that divine nature? Let me give. Oh. I decree in agreement with all the church. You watch, go back 15 minutes more. In Jesus' name, how many of you agree with me?
Amen.
Know that it is done, no matter if you don't see it. So I have 15 minutes more.
Amen.
Jesus' name. Now, I want just to introduce, because we will not be able to deal with it, I want to introduce the how you will be able to operate in the divine nature.
Amen.
There is one thing you should not miss. That's the one thing I will give to you. Right? Let's go to Isaiah 44, verse 1 to 3. Isaiah 44, verse 1 to 3. Everybody read that. Yet, now hear, O Jacob, my servant, and Israel, whom I have chosen. Stop.
Yes.
God is speaking to Jacob. Jacob is a type of Christ. And Christ, in Christ, what has been told to Christ is what is said to us in Christ. So the Spirit of God is talking to us because we are in Christ. And Jacob is the type of Christ. You got it?
Yes.
Okay. So, this is what you say, Lord,
let me hear
what you are saying. Okay. And he's the one that chose us in Christ.
Yes.
Say you are chosen. Say to somebody you are chosen. You are chosen in Christ. Now, verse 2. Thus said the Lord that made thee. Who made you?
The Lord.
So he's speaking to you and I.
Yes.
And formed thee from the womb. Who formed you from the womb?
The Lord.
Jesus Christ.
So he's speaking to who?
Me.
No, some people are not answering. He's speaking to you. To who?
Me.
Okay. Which will
help me?
Which will
help me?
You know, when God decides to help you,
yes.
God said, and that's why I'm telling you, many are reading it, but they're not hearing God telling you today. No matter what you are going through, God decided that he will help you. Is here, God decided to help you. That's why you are here. That's why you are here. It's a rhema word to you that God is saying today. If you don't hear anything, God is saying here today, I have decided to help you. My people, I have decided to help you. My children, I have decided to help you. My help is on the way. And because of that, let every fear vanish from you, my servant. And thou, Jesus, whom I have chosen. For the reason why and how he is going to help you. So how God is going to help you? Huh? You see that? Some people think it's when God comes and give you this. When God comes and do this. When God come and tell you this. When God come. No. You have to understand the help of God. God can do nothing for you but his help. You know, this is my help, right?
Yes. Amen.
The Lord said he gave her to help me. So her mission is to help this man. Help me in financially. Give it. Buy my suits. The good food that I should eat after church. Kenyan tea, Uganda's tea, all those should come from you. The fish from Indonesia, the way they.
God heal, pass on your phone, man.
All the list. I should not look anywhere else but to my help. Said David said, I lift up my head to the hills.
Whoa.
From whence my help come from. My help come from the Lord. The one who made the heaven and earth. So you should be focusing on your help. And I'm looking at my help.
Amen.
To eat cassava.
Amen.
Ah, la. Glory to God. There is another sauce that I discovered this week. Yakatalabos. Now this one is terrible. Any other sauce in which you put this one become excellent. You take one that is not excellent. You put this one sauce that I discovered this week. The first one become excellent.
Amen.
It's like a joker, when you're playing cards.
Yeah, yeah.
The joker.
Yeah.
The joker sauce. But unfortunately, I would have invited you better. But I don't have enough for myself. So the good charity start by yourself. The day I will get enough for myself, then I will invite you, my friend. I can sense that he has saliva. One day, it's not clear, but one day. So you have hope. Some people, those who eat a lot, no, they have no chance. No, we can go to TJ Friday. So, the help. This is the help of God. The help that God is sending to you is not this one. You understand?
Yeah.
You have to know this help that is coming from above. Look at that. For I will put water upon him that is thirsty and flood upon the dry ground. I will pour what? Upon the seed and my blessings upon it. What all of us? The help, the only help God has for you is his spirit. And it's the spirit now who work out everything else. The miracle you need, the breakthrough, the finances, the healing, the deliverance. It's the spirit now who work everything. But the help of God is his spirit. So now look at the way God put it. He said, not only you, even thy seed is God.
Amen.
Even because this, he will pour upon you. He promised also to pour upon your seed.
Amen.
And your offspring.
Amen.
Look at that. Amen. And my blessing. God called his spirit my blessing. So when you are looking to the bread as your blessing, you are looking to the to the miracle as your blessing, you are confusing things.
Yes.
Because the blessing of all blessing is this one.
Yes.
This one. So the Spirit of God is the greatest blessing of all blessings. You can have all the other blessings, but you are still limited. But when you have the Spirit of God, that means all the other blessings, he can work them out in your life. There is only one thing you need now, so that the Spirit will work all these things in your life. You want to know that? In 7 days.
Next week.
You want to know that?
Yes.
Okay, Sunday. He's not agreeing. So because of you alone.
Okay.
Because of you, eh? The people will hear. But it's because of you.
Amen.
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 Now look at this. I will pour water upon him. Not all those who are him. Him that is what?
Thirsty.
That's why this message is spiritual thirst.
Yes, yes.
If your thirst is carnal, forget it. Your thirst must be spiritual.
Yes.
And the thirst is the key that caused God to pour unto you.
Yes.
The thirst. Even flood. If the ground is not dry, God cannot send flood. If you have a wrong thirst, you are thirsty after the things of the earth, nothing will come from above. He received it. Wait, keep on making like that. If you are thirsty of the things down here, that is what is burning in your heart. That's what the message is. The fire of thirst, of spiritual thirst. What is burning in your heart should not be down here.
Mm-hmm.
It should be the thing above.
Yes.
Are you getting it?
Yes.
I will pour my spirit upon thy seed. And now, look at quickly, and I close. John 7. I started 12. I said to myself, 45 minutes. I still have just 2 minutes and a half. And I'm close. I respect my word. 7:36, 37. Read here. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man what? You understand? What kind of thirst is in your heart is capital. It has to be spiritual, not carnal. You have to check your heart. The church must repent.
Yes.
Because of that. What kind of thirst is in the heart? Let him come into me. Because if he comes without this thirst, the right thirst, you cannot receive.
Yeah.
He that believe on me, as the scriptures has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living waters. Verse 39. And Jesus was speaking about 39. He was speaking about the spirit whom those who believe should receive. For Jesus was not. But this spake he of the spirit which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. Now that Jesus is glorified, we can receive the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Everything is ready. But the only thing that is not ready is which kind of thirst is in your heart. I pray that the Lord will grant unto you and I the spiritual thirst.
Amen.
The thirst that will cause heaven to be open and the Holy Ghost to come.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, let the thirst that will attract the Holy Ghost come in the heart of every man, every woman, every boy and girl in this place. In the name of Jesus. Change all the thirst of our hearts and give us your own thirst. The thirst that you want us to have. Let that thirst come into our heart. The spiritual thirst for the things that are above. The thirst for the Holy Ghost. The thirst for your presence. The thirst for your glory. The thirst for your power. The thirst for the move of your spirit. The thirst for the fullness of the Holy Ghost. The thirst to see Jesus testify to the world. The thirst to be used by you as the instrument of Christ to testify of him. Let that thirst be imparted into the heart of all those who are hearing right now in the name of Jesus. Let your spirit come and impact that thirst into our heart now. Change our heart. Remove the false thirst. Remove the carnal thirst. We repent of the carnal thirst. And we pray, oh God, that from this day, the thirst, the spiritual thirst will start burning in our heart. Let the thirst to see souls saved, captive liberated, the kingdom of God coming on earth. Let that thirst be burning in our heart. In the name of Jesus. Come on, pray for yourself. Take the hand of one person. Agree that the thirst will change. Agree on it. I said pray. Open your mouth and ask God. Say, oh Father, change my thirst today. The thirst of my heart. Let my heart be transformed. Give me the spiritual thirst. The thirst for the things above. The things of the spirit. In the name of Jesus. Help me to remove the carnal thirst in me. The thirst for things down here. Lord, remove this thirst from my heart. In the name of Jesus. Do a surgery in my heart. Let the thirst that attract your spirit be in my heart today, in the name of Jesus. Father, do a surgery in my heart today. Oh, rapapapapapa. Peripakota rabost. Iprelebo cantoria basa. Reprelebo sicatoria basa.